Humanitarian aid volunteering allows young people aged between 18 and 35 years old to volunteer in third countries affected by man-made or natural disasters, and to improve the living conditions of people in need. Volunteering can take place in third countries which are neither EU member states, nor third countries that are officially part of other actions of the programme. Humanitarian aid volunteering projects should contribute to strengthening the capacities of vulnerable or disaster-affected communities, support their sustainable and inclusive development, and ensure a high level of safety and security for volunteers. To ensure that, they must be in line with the humanitarian aid principles of humanity, neutrality, impartiality, and independence. The projects and volunteers need to follow the Do No Harm principle, making sure that they do not create an unintended negative impact, increasing people's vulnerability to both physical and psychosocial risks. At the same time, to ensure the safety of participants, volunteering under this strand may only take place in third countries where humanitarian aid activities and infrastructure are already in place, and where there are no ongoing armed conflicts. The following activities are supported under volunteering in the humanitarian aid strand: individual volunteering, volunteering teams, and complementary activities. Individual volunteering can last between 2 and 12 months, and it provides young people with the opportunity to carry out tasks needed to support the activities undertaken by the host organization, such as communications, finance and accounting, administration, or other support activities. Volunteering teams allow groups of 5 to 40 participants, coming from at least 2 different EU member states or third countries associated with the program, to volunteer together for a period between 2 weeks and 2 months. Examples of activities of the volunteering teams could range from distribution of food, non-food items, and cleaning of a specific area, to organizing some animation activities in refugee camps, etc. Volunteering teams support the participation of people with fewer opportunities due to the short duration and participation in a group. To support inclusion even further, additional support measures and funding that allow participating organizations to better accommodate and cater for the needs of young people with fewer opportunities are available. The support needed should be clearly specified, and project activities need to be designed in an inclusive and accessible way. Complementary activities are related to the existing projects, and they are designed to increase the impact on local and/or regional level and the value of volunteering and solidarity in general. Complementary activities can contribute to the capacity building of local organizations and communities and create a feeling of ownership by actors at a local level. They could include meetings, coaching, conferences, job shadowing, training courses, practical workshops involving local youth, etc. All organizations that wish to take part in humanitarian aid volunteering need to obtain an appropriate quality label. When applying, organizations can choose one of the following roles: the support role, which, among other things, enables the organization to submit project applications and coordinate partnerships for humanitarian aid volunteering projects, and the host role. Quality label applications for humanitarian aid can be submitted on a continuous basis to the executive agency, and, if awarded, they will be valid for the entire duration of the programming period. Profiles of all organizations holding this quality label are published in a database on the European Solidarity Corps portal, which is the place to advertise activities and search for potential partners and participants. If you are interested in making an impact where it is the most needed, then humanitarian aid volunteering is certainly an action worth exploring.